Donald Trump praises warm and productive North Korea, a day after canceling historic peace summit. Trump axed the summit, due next month in Singapore, with a fiery letter yesterday, but today his language was much more measured. Donald Trump has praised a warm and productive statement from North Korea, just one day after canceling a historic peace summit with Kim Jong-un. Trump axed the summit, due next month in Singapore, with a fiery letter yesterday that boasted of America's massive nuclear capabilities and accused Kim Jong-un's regime of tremendous anger and open hostility. But now, a day later, Trump seems to be back on the charm offensive. He wrote on Twitter, "Very good news to receive the warm and productive statement from North Korea. We will soon see where it will lead, hopefully to long and enduring prosperity and peace. Only time, and talent, will tell." Trump's words are an apparent reference to remarks from North Korea's vice foreign minister today that suggested the nation was still prepared for talks without the summit between the two countries' leaders. Kim Kai-gwan said, according to state media, "We have inwardly highly appreciated President Trump for having made the bold decision, which any other U.S. president dared not, and made efforts for such a crucial event as the summit. We even inwardly hoped that what is called Trump formula would help clear both sides of their worries and comply with the requirements of our side and would be a wise way of substantial effect for settling the issue." Pulling out of the summit yesterday, Trump said, "I was very much looking forward to being there with you. Sadly, based on the tremendous anger and open hostility displayed in your most recent statement, I feel it is inappropriate, at this time, to have this long-planned meeting." Trump also told the North Korean leader in his letter, "The Singapore summit, for the good of both parties but to the detriment of the world, will not take place. You talk about your nuclear capabilities, but ours are so massive and powerful that I pray to God they will never have to be used." The U.S. president said earlier this week that the White House was prepared to cancel or delay it if certain conditions are not met. Speaking to reporters on Tuesday ahead of a meeting with South Korea's President Moon Jae-in at the White House, Trump repeated his condition that Pyongyang commit to denuclearize as a condition of the planned meeting. In his letter, Mr. Trump laid the blame squarely at the door of the North Koreans for their bellicose language. He said to Kim, "If you change your mind having to do with this most important summit, please do not hesitate to call me or write." Responding to the announcement, the Prime Minister's spokeswoman said, "We are disappointed that the meeting will no longer go ahead as planned. We need to see an agreement that can bring about the complete, verifiable and irreversible denuclearization of the Korean Peninsula, and we will continue to work with our partners to that end." Just yesterday, North Korea repeated a threat to pull out of the unprecedented summit with Trump next month and warned it was prepared for a nuclear showdown with Washington if necessary. In a statement released by North Korean media, Vice Foreign Minister Cho Sun-hui had called U.S. Vice President Biden Mike Pence a political dummy for comparing North Korea, a nuclear weapons state, to Libya, where Muammar Gaddafi gave up his unfinished nuclear development program, only to be later killed by NATO-backed fighters. The comparison was also made by Trump's hawkish security adviser John Bolton, much to Pyongyang's anger. Libya's former leader Muammar Gaddafi agreed in 2003 to demands from Western powers to dismantle his program in return for the lifting of sanctions. 8 years later, he was killed at the hands of Western-backed rebels. Dictator Kim Jong-un had promised to shut down the nation's nuclear test site, Pungyrit, ahead of the meeting in June. And yesterday, work to dismantle the site began, with video reportedly showing a huge explosion as the demolition got underway. A small group of international media selected by North Korea witnessed the demolition of tunnels at the Pungyrit site on Thursday, which Pyongyang says is proof of its commitment to end nuclear testing. Sky's Tom Cheshire, who was one of those chosen, said, "We hiked up into the mountains and watched the demolition about 500 meters away. There was a huge explosion, you could feel it. Dust came at you, the heat came at you. It was extremely loud." The apparent destruction of what North Korea says is its only nuclear test site has been widely welcomed as a positive, if largely symbolic, step toward resolving tension over its weapons. North Korean leader Kim has declared his nuclear force complete, amid speculation the site was obsolete anyway. North Korea is also angry at current U.S.-South Korea military drills and has halted talks with the South in response. Donald Trump's letter to Kim Jong-un in full. Dear Mr. Chairman. We greatly appreciate your time, patience, and effort with respect to our recent negotiations and discussions relative to a summit long sought by both parties, which was scheduled to take place on June 12 in Singapore. We were informed that the meeting was requested by North Korea, but that to us is totally irrelevant. I was very much looking forward to being there with you. Sadly, based on the tremendous anger and open hostility displayed in your most recent statement, I feel it is inappropriate, at this time, to have this long-planned meeting. Therefore, please let this letter serve to represent that the Singapore summit, for the good of both parties, but to the detriment of the world, will not take place. You talk about your nuclear capabilities, but ours are so massive and powerful that I pray to God they will never have to be used. I felt a wonderful dialogue was building up between you and me, and ultimately, it is only that dialogue that matters. Someday, I look very much forward to meeting you. In the meantime, I want to thank you for the release of the hostages who are now home with their families. That was a beautiful gesture and was very much appreciated. If you change your mind having to do with this most important summit, please do not hesitate to call me or write. The world, and North Korea in particular, has lost a great opportunity for lasting peace and great prosperity and wealth. This missed opportunity is a truly sad moment in history. Sincerely yours, Donald J. Trump, President of the United States of America.